Good day, everyone. It's time for weather news with J7409. The name you know, the news you can use when it comes to weather you always need to be aware. What's going on today? Well, that big nasty snowstorm should start to wind down and move slowly but surely and get on out of the U.S., but it is moving up towards Canada for all my friends up there. Other than that, the biggest weather story is the chance of severe weather and tornadoes coming up. I made a video yesterday. It's up. I suggest that all of my subs watch it. Looks like I was pretty much close to what might happen, and I'm going to show you all of that and more coming up in Weather News with J7409. First, we're going to start off with the severe weather risk. This is for today, of course, Friday, the 12th of April, 2019. The map you're looking at, that's what this is for right now. And so far as severe thunderstorms, we've already had some in Kentucky and Indiana this morning. We've already had some. Some of them were producing hail, and as you can see, they're not in the marginal or the slight risk. They're just in where thunderstorms could pop up. Now, isolated damaging wind gusts and hail are possible today across parts of the central Appalachian Mountains this afternoon. Now, these storms have a good chance of having some large hail, and a few damaging wind gusts will also be possible early tomorrow morning across parts of west central and north central Texas. And I'm going to show you a map, and what I put in my video yesterday, I'll put a link where it says watch up above. You go check that out, and I'll also put it at the end of this video. You really need to be aware, folks, of what might happen. Now let's concentrate on tomorrow, Saturday. Okay, right in this area, it has moved up in strength, as you can see. Now, for portions of Texas, a little bit right in here, eastern Texas, Louisiana, Mississippi, and Arkansas, you guys are now up to a 45% chance of severe weather, as I showed you yesterday. You guys could have some things that turn into tornadoes. And then, of course, it decreases 30% in eastern Texas, Mississippi, where the red is. The yellow is 15%. The 5% is the brown area. We also have some 5% chances up in the Piedmont and in southern and eastern Virginia. But let's concentrate on Texas right now. East Texas, eastward to South Tennessee, Mississippi, and western Alabama. Now, this potentially significant severe weather, it is expected to evolve across portions of the south central U.S., focused from Arkansas to Texas to Louisiana and the lower Mississippi Valley area. This is all because of a seasonably strong southern stream storm system, and it's going to advance across the region. Now, with the moist low-level air mass with an evolving warm sector undergoing ample daytime heating, with a mixed layer of Cape anywhere from 1,000 to 2,000 JKG range, it is expected to evolve by early to mid-afternoon tomorrow. Now, you know, this is what it looks like. Timing on these things, you cannot do. Or I can't anyway. But I'm just trying to warn you guys, it's going to happen. Now, the increasing ascent associated with the eastern advance of the upper system, it should result in an increase in convection by early afternoon. Now, it's looking like the band of storms are going to develop near the front with some linear upscale growth with time, and while more cellular convection evolves ahead of the band. Now, at this time, the banded convection appears likely to evolve across East Texas. That should be where the first really nasty storms start, folks, with more cellular storms affecting northern Louisiana and southern Arkansas by mid-afternoon, and then spreading across the Mississippi Delta region into western Mississippi by mid to late afternoon. Given the very strong wind field accompanying this system, the flow is going to veer and increase with height from southeasterly to south to southwesterly and reach 60 to 70 knot winds at the mid levels. Now, what is all this going to cause? Well, organized rotating updrafts more than likely are going to evolve with several of these cells. Now, along with locally damaging winds and hail, strong tornadoes may also occur with a few of the most intense storms with these really high storms. Now, the convection is going to continue spreading eastward through the evening and into the overnight hours, while the prefrontal cellular convection should diminish overnight, and semi-organized bands of storms with embedded rotating updrafts. These supercells, folks, I'm telling you, there's something else right now in this system. And these updrafts and continued severe tornadoes potential will keep on going on, and it will cross the central Gulf Coast states through the end of the weekend. Now, it's looking like, so far as North Carolina and Southeast Virginia vicinities go, it's going to be a little lower, of course, but we could still have hail. We could still have some gusty winds. Who knows? Tornadoes, you just can't predict them right on the spot. So, folks, be careful in any of these areas, particularly this area. You live anywhere in these areas, be aware of what's going on around you, and be aware up here also. But I'm telling you, all of these areas here, please be safe. And I will connect my video to the end of this one on severe weather if you haven't had a chance to see it. And wrapping it up for today, we have the NAM 12K surface reflectivity map, courtesy of Tropical Tidbits. Of course, this runs for the next 2.5 to 3 days, so let's turn it on. And what is happening? Well, that strong storm system responsible for bringing 1 to 2 feet of snow to portions of Nebraska and South Dakota. It's going to lift north into Canada today while it weakens. However, gusty winds are going to remain a concern along with falling snow earlier in the day, but it will stop. And the visibilities could create some blizzard conditions from eastern South Dakota into southeastern North Dakota and western Minnesota. But that should be really in the early morning hours, and that should get much better as the day goes on. Now, additional snowfall after sunrise will be greatest across northeastern Minnesota, where an additional 2 to 4 inches is expected, and some lighter accumulations elsewhere. Temperatures for today will be a solid 20 to 30 degrees below mid-April averages from Nebraska into South Dakota, Minnesota, and northwestern Iowa, with a gradual moderation into Sunday. But even when Sunday gets here, folks, it's still going to be below average temperatures that you're used to for April. Now, another big story is going to be tied to a spring storm forecast to impact portions of the southern U.S. for the weekend. An upper level disturbance is going to pass over Arizona and New Mexico today, bringing higher elevation snow to the four corner states. And the greatest accumulation should fall in northern New Mexico, where roughly 6 to 12 inches are forecast. Low relative humidities and gusty winds across portions of West Texas, including the Big Bend National Park area, will again lead to favorable conditions conducive to the spreading of wildfires today. Be careful. Now, a little farther east, rain's going to develop tonight across the central and northern Texas area into Oklahoma as the upper level system tracks east. Also, some wet snows likely for the Texas and Oklahoma panhandles tomorrow morning as the temperatures are going to fall well into the 30s. Now, heavy rain with possibly flash flooding will set up from Arkansas, Louisiana, and Texas into the middle and lower Mississippi valleys tomorrow, Saturday, where 2 to 4 inches of rain could be possible. Also, we have that chance for severe thunderstorms. They're in place and for portions of eastern Texas, northern Louisiana, southern Arkansas, and far west central Mississippi. Now, all severe hazards will be possible, including tornadoes, large hail, and straight line winds. And this heavy rain that's embedded in the thunderstorms will translate east. It's going to move east during the day on Sunday toward the East Coast, where the temperatures will remain a little above average. Across the Pacific Northwest, we have a brief lull in unsettled weather. It's going to occur late today and tonight before the next storm system reaches the coast early tomorrow morning. This next system will be a quick mover, bringing modest amounts of rain and higher elevation snow to interior portions of the Northwest for tomorrow and tomorrow night. And that's what the weather's looking like, folks, for today, Friday, April the 12th, 2019. If you would like to help me grow my channel, please share this information with your friends, family, and on your social media. Please ask them to subscribe, because severe weather is a real possibility tomorrow in the areas that I have pointed out and told you about. People need to be aware. I would appreciate it so much. Thank you for everything you do for me. I love you so much. Peace, love, and kindness to each of you. Thanks for watching.